When we are doing the associate financial planning module, in investment planning, we understand security markets and products in further detail. When I say further detail, the entire theory, the entire problem solving, concepts understood both from theory and problem solving. Let's understand the concept of the mutual fund. A mutual fund is a trust that pools the savings of a number of investors who share a common financial goal. Money collected through the mutual fund is then invested in various investment opportunities, shares, debentures, and other securities. The income earned through these investments and the capital appreciation realized are shared by its unit holders in proportion to the number of units owned by them. Mutual fund is a pass-through intermediary in true sense of nature. Difference between balance sheet of bank and a mutual fund. Mutual fund balance sheet would look something like this. On the liability side, you would have the unit capital. On the assets, you would have investments in financial securities and other investments. The bank balance sheet, on the other side, will have liabilities comprising of share capital and deposits and assets having loans and advances. So please understand the difference here is whatever share capital here, in this case, it is the units from the various unit holders. So this is a difference in the balance sheet between a mutual fund and a what mutual fund is not. A mutual fund are not get rich quick investments. Mutual funds are not risk-free investment, but strictly regulated and controlled. Mutual funds are not assured return investments. Mutual fund is not a universal solution to all investment needs. Benefits of mutual fund investing: professional investment management, risk reduction through diversification, convenience, unit holders account administration and services, reduction in transaction costs, regulatory protection, and product variety. Product loss classification by organization structure. Mutual fund products can be classified on the basis of how the scheme is organized in terms of issuing redeeming units. On the basis of organizational structure, products are classified as 1. Open-ended schemes, 2. Closed-ended schemes, 3. Interval schemes, or 4. Split funds. We'll do them later when I do problem solving. Open-ended schemes: continuous sale and purchase of units at NAV or NAV related prices. Investor can enter and exit the scheme anytime during the life of the fund. The ongoing entry and exit of investor implies that the unit capital in the open-ended fund would keep changing on a regular basis. The scheme does not have specific time frame. The key feature of an open-ended scheme is liquidity. Closed-ended schemes means any scheme. Closed-ended schemes means any schemes of a mutual fund in which the period of maturity of the scheme is specified. Investors can buy units of a closed-ended scheme from the new fund house during its NFO, that is the new fund offer. To provide liquidity to the investors of such units, listing is compulsory for closed-ended schemes. Since post-NFO, sale and purchase of units happen to or from a counterparty in the stock exchange and not to or from the mutual fund, the unit capital of the scheme remains stable. Can be converted into open-ended schemes by passing a resolution by majority of unit holders. These mutual fund schemes disclose NAV regularly on a weekly basis. Interval funds. Interval funds combine feature of both open-ended and closed-ended schemes. They are largely closed-ended but become open-ended at pre-specified intervals. The benefit for investors is that unlike in a purely closed-ended scheme, they get liquidity through the fund house itself, of course, during the pre-specified time interval. No redemption, repurchase of units are allowed except during the specified transaction period. I'll go one slide back. Assets under management or AUM. So under AUM, as on a particular date, number of crores, types and category wise, so you'll have open-ended, closed-ended, interval funds, total. On this side, you'll have income, equity, balance, liquid, money market, gilt, ELSS, equity, gold, ETF, other ETFs, fund of fund, investing overseas. All this will be done further when I'm going through the session. This is how an AUM chart would look like. Product classification by portfolio management. Mutual fund schemes can be classified into two categories on the basis of how funds are being managed. We've done this before, the passive funds and the active funds. So breakdown of investment judgment, return, and risk. So one, market beta or market risk, group industry growth, cyclical stable, extra market covariance, or group risk, industry risk, individual stock, residual or specific. So active strategies and passive strategies come into picture here. As I previously mentioned, passive means I'm only going to copy the index. So let's look at active in further detail. Actively managed funds are funds where the fund manager has the flexibility to choose the investment portfolio within the broad parameters of the investment objective of the scheme. The fund manager take market timing and or group rotation and stock selection decisions depending on the objective of the scheme. Since this increases the role of the fund manager, the expenses for running the fund turn out to be higher, well capped by SEBI regulation. Investors expect actively managed funds to perform better than the market benchmark. Passive funds, these funds are managed passively. The fund manager does not take the market timing and group rotation and stock selection decisions. These funds invest on the basis of specified benchmark index. As I previously mentioned, just copying the index. Hence, a popular category of these funds is index funds. The portfolio as well as the performance of the scheme replicate the specified benchmark. These are not designed to outperform the market. Since the portfolio is determined by the index itself, the fund manager has no role in deciding on investment. Therefore, these schemes have low expense ratios and are expected not to beat the market, just perform as per the market and give returns less than the market. Index funds are portfolio of securities which have been specifically designed to represent the characteristics and attributes of a chosen target index. Index funds can be constructed in a variety of ways. A portfolio which comprises of all the stocks which comprises the index in the same proportion is known as fully replicated fund. On the other hand, a sampled index fund means investment only in stocks which are part of the index. Index funds are mounted on not only in equity indices but also on bond indices. Advantage of index funds, diversification. Since index schemes replicate to a large extent the market index, they provide diversification across various sectors and segments. Low costs, index schemes are passively managed, as a result of which costs such as those relating to management fees, trade execution, research, etc. are kept relatively low. Transparency, as indices are predefined, investors know the securities and proportion in which their money will be invested. Next category is exchange traded funds. Exchange traded funds, popularly known as ETFs, provide exposure to selected index funds. Unlike listed close-ended funds, which trade at substantial premiums or more frequently at discounts to NAV, that is the net asset value, ETFs, exchange traded funds are structured in a manner which allows to create new units and redeem outstanding units directly with the fund, thereby ensuring that ETFs trade close to their actual NAV. Working of ETFs. ETFs are usually passively managed funds wherein subscription redemption of units work on the concept of exchange with underlying securities. Units can also be bought and sold directly on the exchange. Funds can also be managed under ETF structure active, and actively managed ETFs have made their entry into the Indian market. Benefits of exchange traded funds. ETFs have all the benefit of indexing, such as diversification, low cost and transparency. As ETFs are listed on the exchange, cost of distribution are much lower and the reach is wider. The structure of ETF protects long-term investors from inflows and outflows of short-term investors. Tracking error of ETFs is likely to be lower than a normal index fund. ETFs are highly flexible and can be used as a tool for gaining instant exposure to the equity markets, equalizing cash or for arbitraging between the cash and futures market. So let's look at a comparison of an ETF with an open-ended fund, index fund. So open-ended fund and an ETF, fund size is flexible and ETF also is flexible. Availability is a fund itself. In case of an ETF, through exchange where listed, the fund itself. Liquidity provider is a fund itself. The liquidity provider is a stock market of the fund itself. Sale price at NAV plus load, if any. And in case of the ETF, real time, very close to actual NAV. So this completes our first session. The next session, we're going to look at product classification by investment objectives.